Our goal is to have multi-cloud by design, and we enjoy being customer zero for many of these technologies. And with our workload-driven approach, we've been able to break down barriers in this multi-cloud environment, keeping data and apps flowing between the cloud and the data centers. But I'm thrilled about some of the things that have been announced over the last couple days. So I'd like to bring Magi Kapoor to show off some of the latest efforts that allow customers to achieve a better cloud experience in our APEX portfolio. So welcome, Magi. Welcome.
Welcome. It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, it is awesome to have you. You know, so many customers, they want to place workloads wherever they need. So how can APEX help customers innovate faster?
You know, now more than ever, we need to send workloads ground to cloud and cloud to ground easily and seamlessly so that you can innovate faster.
Well, we can't wait to innovate faster. But, you know, as an IT leader, I'd just love to know, how can APEX simplify my multi-cloud world?
Let me show you how these services work together to help applications scale rapidly to new regions while maintaining agility and flexibility between all clouds and on-prem. It all starts in APEX console. That's where IT admins manage their subscriptions. Let's get started.
Let's get started.
Let's begin by configuring some storage assets with APEX Storage for Public Cloud Services. In the APEX Navigator view, we can choose the type of storage and the cloud provider. So in this example, with just four clicks, we can provision either block or file in our in any cloud provider. So we, for our application, we're going to choose block storage for AWS. Next, we get to choose our performance tier by selecting either a balanced or performance optimized option. Then we can even choose the availability zone option. By selecting a multi-AZ option, we get the same resiliency that comes built into our on-prem block storage that can scale up to thousands of nodes. In addition, this comes embedded with storage efficiencies like thin provisioning capabilities. This can result in dramatic total cost of ownership savings for our customers.
Magi, I love it. So we get powerful, familiar, reliable storage for both block and file on multiple public clouds.
That's right, Jen. So once we have sent the job to deploy for storage, it appears on the cloud deployment dashboard. This entire process is secure with RBAC, SSO, IAM, all based on zero trust. It's pretty incredible.
It is. So now I see the cloud deployment is in the green. And, you know, where do I see my APEX assets?
All within the APEX console. You have visibility and control across your entire Dell estate, from on-prem to colo, to edge and the public clouds.
Okay, I love it. I love it. So now I have storage in the public clouds. How do I get my on-premise data? How do I get it there?
It's easy. Again, from the APEX console, a volume mobility group is created by linking our on-prem block storage to the cloud-based storage that we just deployed. So we set up our on-prem source, choose the volumes that we want to copy over, then we choose our target cloud deployment. It's as easy as that to put workloads wherever they need, whether it's on-prem or in the cloud.
So you bring up, that is a lot easier than Jeff was talking about earlier with the complexity that we face as IT organizations. So I love what we're doing for workloads. And with our modernization efforts within Dell Digital, probably 50 to 60% of our apps are containerized and they're such that they're cloud agnostic. How can these APEX services help in the containerized world that we live in?
They absolutely can. We know more and more mission critical applications are becoming containerized, and that requires persistent storage. So the mobility service that we just saw in APEX Navigator enables us to move more than just volumes. after we onboard a Kubernetes cluster, we can subscribe to any of the Dell Container Service modules that you see over here.
Ooh, I see replication, observability, and application and associated data mobility. Look, this gives us a lot of optionality. You know, we all face decisions that we make today have a lasting impact, right? Where we decide to move our workload. So we need to continuously be able to evaluate our application framework and ensure optimal placement.
Exactly. APEX services combine to help optimize app placement to and from any location. So here we'll use our application mobility modules to move applications along with all of its underlying data to the new regions. This way, our developers can focus on developing. Just lift and ship.
These are amazing. I can see a trend where system performance is measured of both on-prem and public cloud.
Absolutely. Dell APEX provides more than just multi-cloud apps. With our common storage layer, we now have seamlessly connected our high-performance on-prem infrastructure to the public clouds bidirectionally. So now, Jen, that we have seen how APEX simplifies our ground-to-cloud complexity, let's take a look at how APEX can bring the cloud experiences on-prem with our APEX cloud platforms that are optimized for Microsoft Azure, Red Hat OpenShift, or VMware. So let's take a look. An app can be created and deployed natively in Azure, or users can decide to deploy them on-prem for cost savings or maybe a performance boost with our APEX cloud platforms for Azure. This flexibility really helps our teams be more productive without having to step into unfamiliar territory.
How so?
Let's see. So let's imagine there is an issue. And if a user wants to investigate and resolve that issue, they can do so by dropping directly into the Dell APEX Cloud Platform extension from within Microsoft's Windows Admin Center. Isn't that cool?
It is very cool. All of these things are amazing, but now I'm going to have another challenge. So the demand for AI, specifically for training models, it's unbelievable across Dell, probably across all of our companies. So we're exploring opportunities, how this could be applied to our customers as are others, but performance and data governance are both key to enterprise AI apps. What do we have?
Yeah, I totally understand that, Jen. And you know, placing AI workloads in public clouds may not be an option for some of the workloads, right? So the Dell APEX Compute provides high-performance bare metal nodes delivered to data centers that combine with other APEX services can support all operating systems and all container orchestrators. So here we are looking to set up our APEX Compute, which you can choose the number of GPUs, the node type, and then select which performance tier you need.
Bare metal delivered in a hassle-free process, so I can see setting some of these up, load up the GPUs, put Project Helix on them, and we're off to the races.
Exactly. The Dell APEX portfolio combined with a common storage layer really bridges the gap between all these different environments. It allows us to deliver an incredible multi-cloud experience, really enabling innovation at every step.
Maggie, I love it, and I'm going to tell you for many reasons, but even after we've decided where to run something, now we have options to move those workloads based on what we're observing or any other criteria. We all like optionality. In fact, we want it, whether it's for performance or cost or resiliency, gives us a lot of flexibility.
Exactly. And, you know, Jen, everything that we have talked about today and you've seen can be renewed as a subscription or can be decommissioned as needed. No more lengthy commitments, No more costly upfront investments. APEX truly helps businesses focus on innovation instead of financial roadblocks.
It's true. It's awesome. Maggie, thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, John, for having
me. I love what you've built. I love it.